Let us now discuss about the first kind of error, which is systematic error. As the name explained, this is the error which could be due to the system. System means here we are talking about it could be the error which can occur due to the instrument chosen. I will explain it later. Or due to the wrong technique taken by the observer. Or we can say, or the wrong observations taken by the observer, and many more which are related to the system of the experiment to be performed. So based on that, these systematic errors are classified as: number one, instrumental error. The next one is due to the wrong technique used. Number three, due to personal error. Right? Next is due to external causes or due to least count error. Now let us discuss all these one by one. Instrumental error, as the name explained, is the error which can be due to the defect in instrument. Either the instrument is manufactured defected or it is worn out, right? Either manufactured defect or it is worn out. Then such kind of errors are called instrumental error. For example, you are having a scale. We know that the scale starts from 0 and then the numbers are provided like this: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and this is 1, then again 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, and so on. Right? Suppose now the scale is worn out from this edge. It means this edge is not here and your scale has started from this position. So while measuring, suppose you are going to measure the length of any paper or the length of anything. So what will you do? You will keep that scale along with that length and you will start measuring from either from 1 to take it the proper measurements, or you start from this taking it as 0.5 if you know about the least count, right? So in this case you may skip these two points, but the actual value that have been taken was from the initial position 0 and you have started from this, so naturally there will be the difference between the values. So that difference between the values is called instrumental error. Now the second one is wrong technique used. Wrong technique used is basically a most common error which mostly occurs while doing the practicals, because this is the method in which you people don't follow the precautions or procedure have been explained to you, right? And you don't understand that and you did it wrongly. In this case, the technique that have been used is wrong technique. For example, let us take a very general example of measuring the body temperature with the help of thermometer. We know that the doctors use the thermometer and measure the temperature by keeping it in our mouth under the tongue, right? And in case of small children, they prefer to keep it under the armpit. We know that we actually don't know. Basically, if we talk about the general person, they don't know that there is a slight difference between the temperatures when we measure it by keeping it under the armpit. Actually, the body temperature is just a few times lower than the measured by keeping the thermometer in the mouth. So it means again the actual body temperature and the measured body temperature differ, and there will be error in the value of the body temperature. So such a kind of example we can take for explaining the wrong technique used. Again, for example, if we take instrumental in which we are talking about the buoyancy. when we put some body under the water, in a water, we, in that case, we mostly ignore the buoyancy effect. For example, when you push the ball or any body inside the water, in that case you are pushing it, but there is another force which is called the buoyant force, which is pushing it upward, right? In this case, that upward force we are ignoring. So the value, measured value and true value varies. Such kind of example are taken for the wrong technique used. Next is personal error. Personal error basically occur when you know about the how to do practical, but you don't know about the precautions to be taken, or you don't know about the sources, what could be the sources of error. In such cases, you mostly ignore these points and the errors occur, since these are due to your personal observation. So that is why such kind of errors are called personal errors. Right, for example, we can take example while making connections of any electrical instrument. What we do, there we are having copper wires wrapped with a cotton thread, right, for connecting wires. Sometimes what we did is we don't follow the precautions, or we don't follow the sources of error, and while connecting, that thread is also taken into account. So in this case, thread is an insulator. And since it is an insulator, so current will not flow through the circuit, as circuit will not complete it. So in this case, the error can occur because the circuit will not work, and we can modify it by using the mind that there may be some problem in the connection. So we will follow that and remove the thread, and the connection can be made properly. So such kind of errors which occurs due to their personal observations are called personal error. Next is external error or external causes. Error due to external causes.